I think I like the Cowboys playbook. Nah, he goes straight too. Remember, like, he's already on that. My first win on my YouTube hill. The rest ain't posted all those on EA Sports, and if it's in the game.
It's the team of the 80s versus the team of the 90s. The Niners, the Cowboys, they're underway. Returning from his end zone is Ringling McCloud. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being. First drive now for the 49ers. They'll be led out by Mr. Irrelevant in the 2022 draft, a guy with something to prove, Iowa State's career passing leader. And that's Brock Purdy. They start on the ground with McCaffrey, and he maneuvers up the middle for three, and it's second down.
Not a huge carry there on first down, but not all of them would be, but still all in all, a positive play for the offense. It's all about picking up at least a few to set up what you're going to do here on second down.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
And the Cowboys are going to take possession of the football.
Is it first play?
That's an interception that rattles the rookie here. First drive on the road.
And you know the discussion going into the game? Centered on, okay, let's get out nice and easy. Take care of the football. We're on the road. You're a youngster. Let's not make mistakes early. But now the conversation will shift to, okay, put it behind you. Move on. Long way to go on this one.
And he ain't buzz ball there.
35 now at the 34-yard line.
Gave it to him.
On second down, Elliott once more. And he gets it down.
Oh, you thought you got kicked.
Only a gain of a yard, but that's all they needed.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offensive coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
On first and 10, Prescott.
What I want him to. Oh, no, man. He ain't running what I want him to. I tried to have him run a different route. I should have threw it away.
So consecutive interceptions here in this one, and maybe setting the tone, Charles, for a game where the defense really takes center stage.
And don't you think that both offenses are really catching a bit from their coaching staff about avoiding these turnovers that we've seen early? I think both teams are trying to find an advantage. We know that. Can one of them break away and take control of this game?
Every time I beat you with a team, you drop over.
They go play action here, Purdy. And outbounds right around the 20. 8 yards that time, able to take off, and the result is a first down.
I haven't met a quarterback yet that didn't enter the league with a massive chip on his shoulder. If he wasn't a first-round pick, they want to show the league that they made a big mistake. Determined to get the first down there, no hesitation left to tuck it and go. I bet he will try to run to an entire defense if it meant reaching that marker.
Drop for a loss there on a nice effort by Osa Odighizuwa.
You gotta give it up for him right there. That's a heck of an athletic move for a big man right in the middle of the line. How about the play he makes there? Nowhere to run, and he finishes that one off for a loss.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
Oh, I love you, dude, man.
Nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back.
Yeah,
that one
ended
up incomplete.
An incomplete pass on that.
I just throw them all over.
Need to come up with something here on third down. Purdy will set up to throw it here.
corner's going to be a problem.
And able to haul it in is Kittle. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it with an eyelash. Dropped at the one. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
I think he has to be saying to himself, how did that not wind up a touchdown? Remember, he just did the tip of the ball to cross the plane. It's not going to get there, but they're going to be...
And across the goal line, into the end zone, touchdown, 49ers.
Oh, you want to hear this? Go.
Christian McCaffrey punching it in from a yard away. And the 49ers use the early turnover to get on the board first here in this one. Gold able to tack on the extra point.
Right, it's now a
7-0 game.
I forgot I said I was posting this one. You're right.
After the touchdown, right. It's Robbie Gold now to kick it away.
He's just close for the mic and he... Who they see?
And this is going to be returned from middle of the end zone. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line.
I just can't get down to the
second drive forthcoming here for the Dallas Cowboys. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving. I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott. Open man right side. It's Lamb.
Who else had to block?
Bounds right at the 40. That'll line up a gain of 27 on the catch and run.
And that's how you shake off the interception you threw on the opening drive. Come back and throw another strike and gain nice yardage. And I give credit to two people on this one. The man throwing the ball and the person calling the plays. They're not shutting him down early in this game.
He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out.
I wish you were fast. I would have turned it up.
12 more yards there and another first down. And this, I mean, it's certainly something to watch out for. He is not afraid to call his own number on plays like that. And here he takes it for good yardage.
And we know this defense prepared all week for this, but sometimes when you see it in person, it goes right out the window.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
Excellent defensive effort to get to him and provide a little contact before the catch could be made cleanly.
On second and 10, Prescott. Man open, that's complete to Dalton Schultz.
Yeah, right over the ball.
Chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 32-yard line. A first down carry by Elliott. And not much running room. Down to the 32. There to stop him on the defensive side, Fred Warner.
Wow, look at the D, man. Why is this
play? Here's second and 9.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the trash man. His ability to sift through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker. Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete.
And he's only hit on two of his first six passes.
None plays, though.
Back regroup here with a big third down coming up.
You gotta be a little more patient, in fact.
On third down, it's Prescott.
Fuck your day.
Here's one that's intercepted.
Oh, yeah, you ain't close enough, though. Who the fuck has nothing over there? Y'all watching this right now? I just want y'all to know I ain't got no pressure right now.
So good move. And he will be out of bounds here. What will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. After 1-7-0.
Man, I threw another piece.
Here to begin the second quarter.
I don't see no plays.
As they've got it with a second and 4 coming up.
Well, I'd be in there in my shoe. I'd go look for my shoe.
Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey. And this
game is lit ass down.
They swallowed up at the line of scrimmage.
Yeah.
On the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a 3rd and 4. Purdy now to throw. this is going to be incomplete. The other day they told us when we've got third and five or less, we have to be able to convert. And I guess every team would say that, Charles, but an opportunity missed there.
What they were trying to tell us is they believe it's a matchup game at that point. And they liked some matchups that they had. Thought they could exploit them. Unable to do so on that.
Ah, this team.
And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line. Birdie to throw it on first down. And that's off the mark.
Yes, incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Again, it's Birdie to throw it.
Ooh, so I did a PD.
But they'll say it's incomplete.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is so coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The
yeah, D.
Home on that last play and forced him to try and throw it through contact and short of the sticks.
Yes. Oh, that's a little deep.
Because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about
the defense to the tile, boy?
Forcing that incompletion.
Only 29 yards
out there. Oh yeah, Dak, come on now.
With a first and 10.
Two for seven.
Dak Prescott getting set to take over once more. And he's been loose with the football early. Interceptions on the first couple of drives as they start again here. We'll see if they can do better. First and 10.
I want to pile it in. Yeah. I ain't trying to.
They'll start the drive with Elliott. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
They keep on the ground with Elliott. And he's going to be down at the 35, gain of 7.
But no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call
both.
It, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
From the 35 on second down, Prescott, he finds his target, it's Schultz. And out of bounds on the other side.
Tell that boy he better get his nose, Pete.
That one good for 20 on the catch and run.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down.
No.
Oftentimes your best bet
is to just my players out of here
and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
Towards the end zone for Brown. And this is intercepted, but they'll say out of bounds. So very close to a turnover in the end zone.
There is something to a game plan when trying to keep a defense honest. With a guy with that type of speed, you do so. Send him deep. Try to throw some air under it and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they were unsuccessful.
Come on, what the fuck is he?
Third interception. Picked off by Fred Warner. And the Niners
that's bad.
Solid field position here as they take over.
That's bad.
45-yard line. The 49er offense set to get this drive.
Let's be playing recordings out right now.
Start following the interception in great field position.
I still ain't pressing though, man. I did that.
Looking deep for Jennings. And this is incomplete.
Glad I came back.
Pretty good that would have been a big play. But he could not pull it in. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Here's Purdy. Open man is Juwan Jennings.
Oh.
And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
Got to go finesse some more plays.
First time they hooked up here. Good for 17 and a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Oh, my God. It's you, baby. I still ain't got no pressure.
Put a little blow to the ball, yeah? Good.
I ain't got no pressure right now.
I'm trying to find some play here.
I still ain't want to get there, man.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. Right after the touchdown to extend their lead, now maybe opening the door a little bit there by allowing starting field position at the 40. Well, not one you see often there as he fails to keep it between the sidelines.
Potter is a penalty every time and
going to give this offense better field position.
And it's every kickoff guy's nightmare, isn't it? Because you don't see yourself doing this, and most of the time you don't. It's absolutely a miss hit, and now your team pays the price. Bad field position for your defense.
First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there. Inside give to Elliott, and just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Now Prescott.
What the fuck, yeah, it ain't. The
fuck? This one's incomplete.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there. But they never did.
They come up to the line now facing a third and 10 after the incompletion. Now Prescott. He'll fire deep downfield from Lamb.
I couldn't have played with the Cowboys the day.
I don't think you mentioned the guys in the other uniform with four interceptions here in the first half.
Oh, you don't mean this is bad.
Yeah, instead of analyzing what's going wrong with him, throwing the ball, the defense, they came in prepared. An excellent game plan, well scouted, and they're taking it away at almost every turn. On second and 7, Purdy.
Tries
to hit Jennings and it's intercepted. Picked off by Anthony Barr. And the Cowboys are going to take possession of the football. Second interception.
You always got to hold your composure.
I think as a rookie, Charles, how much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on it. His teammates are going to check on it. Because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, because two interceptions for him in college and a half. I mean, that just didn't happen. Yeah. Oh, not sure he saw the linebacker there as that's batted down and incomplete.
That incompletion certainly slows things down a little bit and brings up a very important call.
Come on, man, get you rolling. Man, look at my play.
Run and try and get some yardage and make it third and manageable, or challenge the coverage again, hoping for a bigger game.
The throw over the middle taken in. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Out of the gun, it's Elliott. Oh, look at the juke. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9.
No, it's still it, man.
Going to burn the first of their timeouts.
As they talk
things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Throwing Prescott.
Side in their pocket, yeah.
Touchdown Dallas.
Ain't no pressure, man.
A 9-yard touchdown there.
Ain't no pressure. Ain't no pressure. You already know what's going on. I'm tired of it.
Prescott, they're going to throw for it. And he's got it for the 2-point conversion. So they tack on a pair more here to narrow that deficit a bit further.
Yeah, he just made sound weird. I just put a touchdown.
Not even the option to hand the ball off. They got it.
They tried to create space, and there isn't a whole lot of it there for the defense. They got no football.
I'm still playing hard.
Make them catch it behind you because they run out of space with the back line.
Yeah,
but in this case, the offense
He's actually
He'll make it back only to the 10-yard line.
Anytime you feel the kickoff inside your own end zone, you've got to be decisive about whether you're bringing it out or not.
Bad, man.
Sometimes that indecision can really cost you. Bad, that may have been what happened in that play.
Bad, 0-0.
He's got a man complete. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. Just like that, out of danger and up past the 40 now for first and 10. Looking deep for Jennings. Picked up by Trayvon Diggs. And the Cowboys are going to take possession here. 47 yard line. He'll see that he already escaped the pocket. He could have gotten more himself by using his
Yeah, he just made it weird. That ain't weird. I'm stealing on side of
a miscalculation on his part, and he pays for it with the interception. Following the interception, here's Prescott. Now the Niners get there and bring him down. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now, as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott.
I think I could lean that whole go to him.
Is he trying to pull that one?
When I try to catch it.
Thanks to a great defensive effort. Sack on first down, followed by an incompletion. One more good rep. Oh, Prescott stripped. And they will take over at the 26-yard line.
They say you got stripped.
Valley offense going to use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, they step aside.
I'm sorry, the channel step is. I didn't need it to happen, though.
Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today.
Oh, this nigga trash, man. This nigga trash, y'all. This nigga trash.
There's a lot going on in between the years.
There certainly is, and probably way too much, because now he's probably doubting himself a little bit, wondering what adjustments he has to make. But here's what he needs to do. Get through this game. Go to the press conference. Meet it head on. Be ready to shoulder what happened today. And you'll be ready for this game.
And if he can do that as a rookie, that's a great sign of
maturity. Get your ball back.
Unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last.
I really ain't got no plays, though. That's the bad part.
Final play of the half, Prescott. Incomplete on the deep ball.
I've seen this shit before.
So we have reached half time here.
I've been people looking at it, like, man, these niggas trash fool. They really ain't had room to go. As you
Welcome
have
back,
this
halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. It's the Cowboys
I'm still
who
looking
for the
win,
by plus 14. We resume action in the third quarter. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone.
Come on, man. That's the token.
This to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
Man, I know yours. Come on, man. Just the other day, I was fucking.
You don't bench a starter of his caliber, but four first
time rated numbers.
How do you handle it from here?
Well, the easy thing is right away, you try and run the football. Take some pressure off of him, but you know the deep.
Well, I want Pollard in the game.
You want to get all your feet?
Man.
Well, my second thing is, give him throws that are safer, throws that he's confident in, the ones that he likes to make, and that way, he try and get his confidence back up.
Meanwhile, Dax throws into the hands of Schultz here. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. From the shotgun against Elliott. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Prescott now. Got his man there, complete to Gallup. And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line. So from inside the territory now, this is first and 10 at the 47. And a pretty big hole as he's down to about the 40. 45 yards rushing for him now in the ball game. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to see the field and make a run as we just saw there. The goal is certainly to try and make a big play happen and climb back into this game, but you have to be careful. If you overdo it, you could turn it over and hurt your team.
A good chance. This is four down territory if they're unable to convert. But right now looking at a third and three. Here's Prescott. He finds his man complete. That's Schultz.
What's up? Come on. Told y'all, man. Just keep it composure, man.
That third down conversion. Good for 23.
They brought in a heavy set on third down. That usually means running play, but we have seen him throw out of that formation.
Might be a touchdown. Y'all want a touchdown? You want a touchdown? Wound up hitting
for a first down.
Yeah, a touchdown. You talking this shit.
Yeah, man.
Throwing the out
route
and complete. It's Ferguson.
Talk to
the Cowboys are looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line. Pollard.
Okay.
Okay. So it was a passing game that drove him down the field, but when they get close, they trust that man in the backfield. And he took it home.
And they trust their offensive line as well, because so many of these units, they specialize in either pass protection or run blocking.
Just like that, you guys. Just like that.
Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away.
It's a ball game. It's back to ball game. And the kicker keeps a good ball. Thought you ran it back, huh?
Oh, I thought you.
Well, it went to the 22. You would have fat kiss and got farther than
look at the 49ers offense as they make their way out for their first possession of the second half. And Charles, it feels like we're set up for a good second half here. Came out of the locker room, one score game. Now the lead has already changed hands. Well, this offense, they've got an opportunity right now to take that lead right back.
Yeah, and it feels like you're going back and forth.
I'm not saying we're going to
this match, right? And we're just there, you know, heads just keep moving. Which side has it? Which side's going to score? How are they going to go out doing it? A little bit of a challenge for each side trying to match each other.
And that's complete to McCaffrey. They'll wind up getting seven on the play, and that'll bring up second down.
Don't throw no peace, man.
Purdy.
What did he do?
And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
And those two just have been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job.
Look at that boy, DSA.
Still,
because
his talent, you would expect him to have more completions.
Because
on third down, it's Purdy. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they put the heat, and if he pushes out, they're fine with that. And they force another incompletion.
Fourth down try. Here's Purdy. Completes it to the tight end, Kittle. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line. So this drive going to continue following the conversion on fourth. Here's first and 10.
LP. LP.
Right there, because it's all about finding a window on a route like that. He lined up on his left, ran the deep in route over the middle, and the ball was right where it needed to be. Really good trust between quarterback and receiver. Really good completion.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. He can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime Minks had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secure before they slide off and try to
keep it.
Another interception.
And it is caught. Hey,
32-yard line. And you have to wonder, Charles, a game like this, 5 interceptions, what does this do to the psyche of a young quarterback?
Well, based on the fact that he's still out there and he threw a 5th interception, I'm wondering if his head coach believes that he's really strong mentally and wants him to play through it. Because otherwise, you need to get him out and fight another day because...
And now here's another interception.
If I even saw him. Yeah, I just throw that shit. This nigga's not good, man.
I think you and I were a little surprised back earlier in the game when he threw his second interception. I mean, who would have thought a quarterback of his caliber picked now five times?
It's beyond stunning to me because we're used to that with maybe a quarterback with less experience.
Yeah, I love it at home, man. Maybe turn up on Deep Ellum as a hit.
Absolutely. If you would have told me this coming into the ball game, I would have said never. Not in a million years, but here we go.
I know they'd love to take some heat off of that young quarterback, but so far, not much in the running game, and this won't help things either. A loss on that play.
Purdy's throw pulled in by Kittle, and he's going to be taken down at about the 33. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we play three quarters. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. They'll try and pick it up in the camp.
Oh, yeah, we
are. Tough sliding. They lose a yard there on third.
There's no question that coming into this game, this defense is pretty vocal about his desire to take this running back out of his game. And all that pregame whooping has turned into results.
Purdy, big fourth down play. Able to haul it in is Kittle. And he'll be marked down right at the 20.
I had some footage. I don't know why I didn't go to it.
On first down, Purdy. The same target, same result. And he's brought down. It's another first down as they look his way again, this time 19 yards.
And here we are, the fourth quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown.
That's what it is.
And you got both now. This is where you need a
quarterback. They'll take this.
I mean, everybody knows that he is.
San Francisco touchdown. Christian McCaffrey. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Niners have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter. McCaffrey will try to run it in. And he is not going to make it. So they won't be able to move this lead up to a touchdown as it will remain a five-point ball game.
That's how it sounds. 2 points of bird. Damn, boy, got a close game. Chill out.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould right, now to kick it away. Here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. Probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. Dallas offense set for this next drive. We certainly have a good one on our hands. They're trailing after that last touchdown, but now a chance for this offense to try to snag that lead right back here in the fourth quarter. So Prescott to the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 16. They'll run with Pollard to begin the drive. And it works for about three at second down. The last run got three. Now here's second and 7. To throw is Prescott. That's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll take this to the other side of the field before going out of bounds. A big play on the catch and run.
Yeah, right there, yeah.
4 yards.
That could very well be the winning play in this game. A touchdown, that gives him the lead, and it took a major step towards getting there with that big play right there.
Prescott on first down. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. Coming up on second and 7. They run straight ahead here with Pollard. And he's going to have this pretty close to a first down as the tackle is made at the Niners 37. The battle in the trenches never more important than right now. This is third and inches. Prescott to throw it. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes it.
Let's go!
The 20. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. Looking to throw, Prescott.
Because he ain't like it.
Second down. Another throw there off the mark, and obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem.
Oh, you
know, they always tell you, no matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence.
Man, because I can't find no plays, like... Shit, I played that day.
Passing game's off balance, and the defense is taking advantage. Hey, let's face it, you can put any Halloween costume on him. You're not going to be able to disguise him, because for a tight end of his size, difficult to sneak him anywhere, but that's what they tried to do. Lined up on his right, tried to work his way back to his left, but just a minimal gain as the defense was able to react quickly.
Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
What an excellent defensive stand there in the red zone. Nice tight coverage. They certainly recognized how important it was to bring up fourth down here.
Shit. But I need a first. God dang.
Desperation time. Prescott on fourth.
Oh, that's bad.
And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. The Cowboys here unable to convert on fourth down. And the 49ers are going to get the football
back. That's sweet. I can imagine doing this shit though, for real. If I lose, put this shit right there.
Good chunk of time on the clock and the timeouts.
Yeah, not only do they have the timeouts, as you just noted, they're going to get an extra one with the 2-minute warning.
Yeah,
and that's
going
to help them midway. So, in a sense, they have four timeouts in their pocket. The big thing, stopping them on defense now. They can't let them get a first down and make them use their timeouts and get a fresh set of downs. They've got to stop them right here. And if so, they've still got an opportunity.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They'll try and burn some clock now with McCaffrey. And he's going to have a Niners first down as he'll take this up to the 38-yard line.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. Defensively, a solid response after giving up back-to-back first downs. Now a timeout called for by the defense as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Now it looks like he'll throw here.
As
they get it up to the 43-yard line. So my goodness, I would have thought this possible not too long ago, but that turnover there means we have a game again.
Yeah, it's been a completely different team here in the second half. I just wonder on the other side of the field. Where the starters telling them and now guess what? Hope they didn't cut the tape off of their wrists and ankles. They've got to go back out there and play.
Oh, yeah, give me it.
A good start to the drive here. So it's caught out on the left side. Yeah, he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Call that a very strong gain of 24. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
To throw, Prescott. They try to set up the screen.
I seen him. I thought he was going to pick him up.
But it's incomplete. Not much chance of that work. It almost intercepted. It's second down. So he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is it just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
Back-to-back incompletions, but we know this is definitely four down territory. Time not on their side. I don't think they want to try and get the first down in two installments. I think they got to go and get it right here, right now.
Catch is made. It's Schultz on the end round. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. And he'll be stopped just outside
the game for the TV.
The 6 yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. Now Dak. And that one off the mark behind him, incomplete.
Now we're in the situation where the quarterback's got to take full charge of his own. Got to totally command and make sure all eyes are on him. All focus is locked in. Going to call multiple plays and go over different situations and scenarios to make sure everyone is on the same page.
Prescott. And that will be incomplete with a clutch.
That's fourth down.
14 seconds now to go. So this defense, they looked a little shaky.
What the fuck this play was all day, man?
From finishing it off.
They rocked them a little bit on this drive, didn't they? But as you and I both know, it's not how you start.
Nah, about to looking for this hole.
A chance to end it right here.
And he's got it. It's caught for a touchdown. And they have taken the lead here on the final
seconds. See, like that. I've been looking for this play, though. Look at this shit. That's a good ass game for YouTube. Good. What y'all think, YouTube? You think he gonna win still?
Huh?
I gave a good game for y'all, man. I gave a good game for y'all, man. I ain't say too much. I ain't call too much. I wish y'all could see his face, y'all. Like, he was feeling so good this whole game. I mean, he still got time, though. That was smart. That was smart. I told him to try to run the bed.
I got like 3 plays left on the field. Two,
the 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Here comes another drive from this unit, and Charles, there comes a costly mistake on the last possession, an interception in a game that is very close right now.
Ooh, all the white jerseys.
Sting, no matter what the situation, but in a one-possession game, that hurt a little bit more, but this is an excellent opportunity to make a drive. I just don't expect them to try and take huge gambles to make up that momentum in a hurry.
Okay, this is gonna so change.
Hey, how that way back up?
What you say first?
Oh, I
want to see you play.
Yeah.
Oh, you would've called. I'm just trying to see.
Here's Purdy. Is incomplete with a clock showing just
yes, sir. What do you call the defense?
So after all of this, it comes down to one final play.
And just think of what it's going to be, because from this distance, you got to be prepared for everything. Looking laterals, tip balls, you name it. A lot of laterals after a catch.
Yes, sir. Anything can happen, you guys.
Defensively and tackle someone.
That is not playing it incomplete, but a penalty flag.
Heavy,
in the backfield, this might be a roughing call. Well, certainly those are the types of mistakes they're trying to avoid as they attempt to protect this lead late in the game.
And let's face it, they're hoping that this one doesn't cost them in a significant way. Yeah, one guy committed a penalty, but now the entire defense has to pay the price and try to rise up and overcome it.
Now one final throw is not
McCaffrey.
And that is how this one will come to an end.
You didn't like how the other championship game was last year.
On that last play, Charles
was
the
side
of midfield and needed something near a miracle to get it done.
Yeah, the effort. That was good. Very good.
Yeah, so it was a good game for y'all, man. It should have been a blowout, but y'all got what y'all came to watch.